So today we're going to be looking at fitting our overlay Lite 15 system. This is predominantly a low profile system, but it can also be used between the joists as a suspended system as well. The main components of the panel is a high density polystyrene, and the top surface layer is an aluminium foil, which is designed to laterally spread the heat to enhance system performance. The panel is 22mm thick, and it accommodates a 15mm pipe at 200mm pipe centres. So moving on from the panel, before we get to installing, one of the most important things we need to look at is this end return panel. And the reason for this is we've actually got straight runs all the way through the end return panel, as well as the 180-degree bends. Now the idea of this is we actually have to do what we call circuit planning before we actually start the install, which basically means we need to work out how many of these we need to put in to be able to carry the connection pipes to other zones in other areas. So first, today we're going to look at the new Polypipe underfloor heating control pack. Also, we're going to look at the isolation valves and the auto balancing manifold. So first, moving from left to right, we've got the blending valve, which takes a hot supply and a cold supply and ensures that there's a controlled and stable outlet temperature for the underfloor heating system. Moving down from that, we've got a Grundfos UPM3 pump with the Polypipe branding. And at the bottom of that, we've got an elbow. Now, the beauty of this elbow is it enables us to quickly orientate it on the right-hand side of the manifold should we need to. And that's due to these two unions either side being easier to swap out and flip round. Moving on from that, we've got the isolation valves that incorporate temperature gauges, and that ensures we can read a mean flow temperature running into the system and a mean return temperature coming back. So moving on from the isolation valves is the actual manifold itself, which is an auto balancing manifold, which is unique to Polypipe. This incorporates an AFC valve in the manifold, which enables us to, once we've set a flow rate, it maintains that flow rate, whether other circuits have shut down or if other circuits have been set up in terms of the flow rate. So as I mentioned before, what we're doing first is a bit of circuit planning with the end return panels. Now today we're only actually running one circuit, so I'm only running one row of end returns in there because I know that's going to be plenty to get my return pipe back in. If I needed to run more circuits out that way to other rooms, then I would probably use a couple of rows of end returns or however many I need, depending on how many connection pipes I've got running to those areas. So yeah, so I'm just going to carry on, continue up this wall with the end return panels, and then we'll look at putting some actual panels down, how we joint them, and then eventually running some pipe. Okay, so what we've done, we've set our end returns up down the back wall, and now what we're going to do, we're going to infill with panels. We've had to take a little segment off the last end return just to get it fitted in, which is what we'll probably have to marry up with the panels too. Okay, so one of the most important things to remember when we're doing any low profile system, and this is included in that as well, is that we stagger the joints from row to row. So as you can see there, we've got a joint here, so we're going to put a full panel in, and that just ensures that the joints aren't in line, and that's for the strength of the floor. So what we've done, we've infilled with all the panels, cut to size, ensured that we've staggered the joints. Now what we're looking to do is, using our aluminium foil tape, we're going to put that all the way down each column, and that's how we tie the panels together essentially, and it also enables that spread of heat that we mentioned before laterally across the whole of the floor area. So what we've done, we've infilled all the panels, like we said before, we've staggered the joints, we've then taped each joint down each column, leaving for now the horizontal joints, because what our next job is now, we're going to get the pipe in the floor. Once the pipe's in, we can then tape up them horizontal joints as well. So now we're ready to lay the pipe in the overlay Lite 15, Before we do that, what we've done is we've ensured we've cut the pipe nice and flush and square, and we've fully inserted a Polypipe 15mm insert. Next, we're going to push it up through the back and into one of the fittings, the Polymax fittings on the auto balancing manifold. And when we push it in, to make sure that we fully insert the pipe all the way into the fitting, you'll push it through two clicks, one being the O-ring and the second being the grab ring. And once we've done that, we've felt those two clicks, if you just give it a quick tug back test down to ensure that it's fully mounted into the socket. When we do the tug back test, if it pulls out of the socket, we know that it hasn't been correctly inserted. So just before we run the pipe, what we've got at one end of every overlay light 15 panel is a built-in end return. But because of the foil topping, what we need to do is just prep up and cut it with a Stanley knife just to enable us to push the pipe and return it back in and down the other channel. So the pipe we're going to be using is the Polypipe Ultra Flexible Underfloor Heating Pipe. This just enables a quick and easy install. So as we're bringing it off the coil, all we're going to do is use the flexibility of the pipe to push it into the groove. If it's not quite in there, we can just tap it down with our foot. So, as you can see, we've run the pipe in, and what we've done, we've just allowed it to run in the end return panel, the connection pipes. Now, if you had multiple circuits across multiple rooms where there's a lot of connection pipes running back, you'd probably leave an area around the manifold where you didn't put panels or end returns, so you could get the pipes in, clip them to the subfloor, nice at 30mm centres, and into the manifold, and then latex over it. Okay, so as you can see, we've just run a piece of tape along there, and that's where the panel joins to the end return. We've done it over the pipe as well. The major reason for that is once we get this under a 6-bar pressure test, that tape also prevents it from popping out, as well as ties the two together. We're now going to do that on every horizontal joint across the whole of the floor area, and then we're pretty much finished. So that's the Overlay Lite 15 installation complete. Like any low profile system, it's absolutely essential that the subfloor is as level and free from deflection as much as possible. If it is not, then this can cause problems for the finished floor covering later down the line. As for floor coverings, typical floor coverings that would be used over a system like this would be laminates that can be applied directly. Floor coverings such as carpets or vinyls must have an intermediate layer of flooring grade ply. For more information on floor coverings over Overlay Lite 15, please look at our plumbing and heating installation guide.